Okay, so a lot of people might be wondering why the hell I am posting a video like this. And to be honest, I'm still like kind of nervous as I'm sitting here right now, but I want to treat this as kind of like a big sister moment. And when I was going through this, I really wished that there was somebody who was talking about this on the internet as well, who maybe had a similar experience. So that's why I'm doing it. I've always made videos to let people know that like they have a friend on the internet and that they're not alone. And so this is just one of my stories that, as uncomfortable and kind of awkward as it is to tell, I feel could really, really help somebody else. So here we go. Today I wanted to sit down and talk to you guys about a more personal health matter of mine that was going on for about the last year and a half. And now that I'm kind of out of the thick of it and it's pretty much like behind me, I wanted to sit down and talk to you guys about it. Like I said, just in case there is somebody in a similar situation to me, so that they feel like they're not alone. Because when I was going through this, I felt like I was the only person in the world who was struggling with this. I felt like there weren't a ton of people to talk to about it, like besides my doctor. And sometimes it's just nice to have like a girlfriend who understands like what you're going through. So today I wanted to talk to you guys about my struggle with reoccurring UTIs, and a UTI that I had that lasted over a year. I'm also making this video to just kind of stress the importance of like taking your health into your own hands, and especially like being a young woman, the importance of finding the proper doctors for you and your needs, and finding like the right gynecologist. And I'm also making this video because I want to share with you guys what eventually helped treat this like year-long battle that I had. Okay, so let's just start from the beginning. I feel like the more I talk, the more I'll kind of relax, because again, this is like a really wild video for me to be making. So let's go all the way back to July 14th of 2018. I remember the day exactly, because it was the start of a over year-long struggle. I woke up the morning of the 14th, and first thing in the morning I had to use the bathroom, which like isn't uncommon. So I go to the bathroom and all of a sudden I notice that something just doesn't feel right. It really hurt to go to the bathroom. Afterwards there was like a burning sensation as well, and I knew that that wasn't normal, but I didn't really know what it could be. I had showered the night before, so I thought like maybe okay some soap like got up there or something, or like I don't know, maybe it was just like a weird thing that would like, you know, go as quickly as it came on. But that night I wasn't feeling any better. I remember it was super hard for me to fall asleep, and I remember feeling like I had to go to the bathroom like every 10 seconds. And when I would try to go, nothing would come out. So as any young adult does in the middle of the night when they're not feeling great, I started to Google my symptom. And the first thing that came up was a UTI. Now UTIs, or urinary tract infections, are something that are incredibly common among women. Men can get them too as well, but they're especially common among women. And from everything that I was reading, it said that it was something that was very, very easy to treat, or relatively easy to treat, as long as you found a doctor, you know, within the first few days of your symptoms. Now at the time, I was in between GPs. I didn't have a new primary care doctor in the city yet, so I logged on to Planned Parenthood and made an appointment at one of their clinics. I wanted to go to a Planned Parenthood rather than like a City MD or like a Minute Clinic urgent care type of thing, just because I felt like they probably dealt with like vaginal health issues more often. So I made an appointment at one of the clinics here in New York, and the doctors were all incredibly nice. Honestly, like thank God for Planned Parenthood for so many reasons, but especially just for, you know, having a place that is so easily accessible for young women to like make appointments for. So anyways, I made an appointment with the doctor. I did like a urine culture, and then like I just had an exam with her. And from the first, so like they did two things. They did a urine culture that they sent off to the lab, and then they did one right then and there where like they dipped like a little test stick in it. And basically the test stick immediately showed that I did have a UTI. UTIs are incredibly common. Again, I'm not a doctor, but I'm just gonna kind of tell you guys what I know as this video goes on, just because like I have been dealing with them for a while now. But UTIs are incredibly common. They can come from holding your pee for too long. They can come from intercourse. They can often come in tandem with a yeast infection as well. So there are plenty of ways to get one, It's not something to be ashamed of. They're incredibly common. And if you talk to like any of your other girlfriends, I'm sure that at least half of them have experiences as well. They put me on a 7-day antibiotic. They put me on Macrobid, which is like one of the most common UTI medications. I felt good, and then about a week later, my symptoms came back like that. There was nothing that brought them on again. I was living my life exactly how I always had, and my symptoms came back again, this time even stronger. I couldn't get an appointment for that week at Planned Parenthood, so instead I went to a CityMD, which is like pretty much an urgent care place here in the city. And I met with the doctor there, we did another urine culture, and again, it showed that I had a UTI. She puts me on the same medication. This time it was a 14-day dose instead of a 7-day dose. And at this point, I still wasn't like overly concerned. I kind of figured, okay, this is probably pretty common that like you need 2 rounds of antibiotics. I'm sure I'll feel better after this one. So I take it for 14 days. I feel better for about 2 weeks. And then I remember I woke up like towards the beginning, middle of August, in the middle of the night with the same symptoms. And I thought, oh my God, this cannot be happening. Somehow I was able to make an appointment with Planned Parenthood that week. So I did, I went back, I saw the same doctor because I knew that she was kind of aware of like what was going on. And this is when I definitely started to get a little uneasy. She essentially told me that women who have more than like 3 UTIs in the course of a year, it can often be something else, something much more serious. On the list of those things was even cancer. Looking back, I definitely didn't appreciate that she kind of like threw that out there. I know she had to for just like the extensive list of what it could potentially be, but it definitely made me feel a little uneasy. So again, we do another exam, and this time she asks me, would you like to be tested for STDs and STIs? To which I automatically responded no. I've never had an STD. There would never be a reason for me to have an STD. I've never had an STI, anything like that. So I said no. I really do think it's another UTI. However, I just want to get to the bottom of why it could be this. However, at that point, she said just to be on the safe side, she would do another urine culture and swab for UTIs, but then she also did want to do a swab for STDs. At that point, I just said, you know what, like, fine, if it'll make you happy, even though I knew in my heart, like, that was not the issue. But it turns out that was not the issue. It was another UTI. She put me on a different medication this time. I honestly don't remember what it was called. I took that for like 2 weeks. I felt better for about a month, and then the symptoms came back. At this point, I knew that it was time to kind of try a different route. I knew it was time for me to find an actual gynecologist because this was not normal. Up until this point, last year I was 18. There wasn't really a reason for me to have a gynecologist because you don't need a pap smear until you're 21 years old. So you're usually okay with like just having a GP, but I knew that because of what I was dealing with, I needed to find a gynecologist. So I found one online who had good reviews, who I felt comfortable and confident going to. But as it turned out, it was really, really an unpleasant appointment. I tried to explain my situation and this doctor like automatically cut me off. And before I could even finish, she was like, oh, you have an STD. And I calmly said, no, there's no reason that I would have an STD. There's no reason that I would have an STI or anything like that. I'm pretty sure it's a UTI from everything that I've read about and from the, you know, previous times that I've been to Planned Parenthood and urgent care. It's come back as a UTI as well. She got incredibly defensive, wouldn't really let me finish my sentences, and when she pressed me to again get tested for STDs, I ended up leaving the appointment. Because here's the thing, and this is one of the big things that I want to mention in today's video, one of the points that I really wanted to be sure that I made. Obviously, doctors are doctors for a reason. They went to school for years and years and years, and they are people that you should trust. However, you know your body better than anyone. And I feel like as women, oftentimes we aren't taken seriously. We say that we have pain or we say that we feel discomfort and people automatically just chalk it up to something that it isn't, or they kind of laugh it off like it isn't a big deal, or they try and tell you that it's something that you really in your gut know that it's not. So I left that appointment, and honestly, the idea of like trying to find a gynecologist again, and I was kind of like scared to have an experience like that again. So the idea of it just kind of overwhelmed me. So I would say for like the next 3 weeks or so, I tried to treat it naturally. I looked online and took every kind of cranberry medication that I could. I drank cranberry juice until I was floating in it. And let me tell you, I actually hate cranberry juice. So that was like drinking poison to me. I was taking any and every women's probiotic that I saw that was recommended for people who were prone to having UTIs. And to be honest, I was feeling a little bit better. I also don't know, looking back, if it was like a placebo effect a little bit, but I was feeling a little better. So I thought, okay, maybe I'm healing myself. However, about 3 weeks later, I was feeling even worse. My symptoms were back. They were super strong. And because it was kind of like the most convenient, you know, route that was always there, I went back to Planned Parenthood. I spoke with a new doctor this time, and she said that she wanted to put me on a different antibiotic. I want to say this was at like the end of November, beginning of December. Anyways, I took this new antibiotic, and honestly, I was feeling good. And then the first week of January hit, and my symptoms came back one morning, and I was so frustrated that I literally almost wanted to cry. But at this point, I've had about 6 months of what seems to be a continuous UTI, because even though my symptoms would go away for a week, or a week or two, the fact that they were coming back so quickly made me think that there was still bacteria in my body that was causing this. So I went on ZocDoc, which is an app that I cannot recommend enough. You can find literally like any kind of doctor for anything that you need, and you can also search by who takes your health insurance as well. And one of the things that I really wanted to look for was a gynecologist who obviously could like prescribe me antibiotics that would help, but one who also studied like more homeopathic methods as well. Because to be completely honest, I've never been a big like pill taker. I feel like if there's a natural way to fix something, you should try that first. Obviously, if it's like an emergency situation, if I'm like dying, I'm not gonna say no, I'm not gonna take that medicine, like give me some peppermint oil first. But over the course of the first 6 months that I was dealing with this reoccurring UTI and having antibiotics, you know, shoved at me left and right, I realized that like, you know, it was just too much. You know, I felt like it wasn't fixing my problem, and it wasn't, you know, necessarily doing my body like anything that good, because the symptoms would always come back. So I wanted to find a doctor who kind of specialized in both, if that makes any sense, like both medicine practices. So I find a new gynecologist in the beginning of January, and this is where the story kind of starts to get a little better. Basically, I came in for the first appointment that I had with her, and I just told her everything. I explained my symptoms, I explained how long I had been dealing with this, I also explained that there was nothing that was consistently bringing on the UTIs. So it wasn't something that I could make sure like not to do. And for the first time in 6 months of having this issue, she actually listened. She listened to everything that I had to say. She didn't stop me once until I was done, and then she proceeded to ask questions. And she was so kind, and she just never once made me feel ashamed. Because especially at that first doctor that I dealt with, and even a little bit with the doctor at Planned Parenthood, even though I'm sure she didn't mean to, there was always kind of a sense of like, I don't know, I was just kind of made to feel like, you know, I was doing something wrong. Even though I knew that like, I have always been a person who's taken care of myself and taking pride in taking care of myself, and I've always been a very like generally healthy person. And especially because of like the not so great experience I had with the first gynecologist after Planned Parenthood, it kind of made me feel a little bit embarrassed, you know, and I didn't really want to talk about what was going on. And you know, as I was dealing with this, the more and more I researched like reoccurring UTIs in women, the more I realized that like this isn't really talked about at all on the internet. Anyways, back to the appointment. So like I was saying, she really listened to me. She asked me a lot of questions, and then we went back into her exam room for a proper examination and a urine culture that she was going to send to the lab. She said that based on, you know, my symptoms and my situation, it sounded like I was just prone to reoccurring UTIs. However, she said that, you know, macrobid isn't for everyone, so it kind of sounded like while the first few antibiotics that I was put on might have helped my symptoms, it didn't completely get rid of the UTI, so I was still dealing with the same UTI that I had from July. Meaning it was going to be harder to treat because that bacteria had been sitting in my body for almost seven months now. So until the lab results came back, she didn't want to put me on an antibiotic just because she was like, I don't know what's going to work and what's not going to work. So in the meantime, I took, she just gave me a medicine that was more of like a numbing medication. So for like the pain and the symptoms, it would just kind of numb everything, so I wasn't like in pain every time I had to use the bathroom, or you know, I could finally get like a good night's sleep. So we got the first lab test back, and basically she said that there, you know, there's a couple different strains of bacteria that can cause UTIs, and I had quite a few different strains. So she told me it was gonna be a little bit of a process to treat it, but she was confident that she could, which made me so happy because that was the first time in, you know, a long time that I felt like I was in really, really good hands. So basically from July of this year through September of this year, we basically just worked through treating like all the different strands of bacteria that were in my body causing UTIs. And to be quite honest, I'm really glad that I found her because she was honestly amazed that the UTI hadn't traveled to my kidneys yet, because she said, you know, if you've been dealing with the same UTI for 7 months, it's, you know, very, very common that it would eventually travel to your kidneys, and then we would have an even bigger problem. But I think it's because honestly I was drinking so much water during that time, and I was drinking so much like cranberry juice and fluids and just flushing myself out as much as I could, that it didn't travel to my kidneys, and for that I'm super, super grateful. Otherwise, I might be telling a completely different story today. Anyways though, over the course of January through September, we basically worked on treating all the different strands. So what we would do is I would, you know, do a urine culture, she would send it to the lab would get it back to us, show us what the most like prevalent strand was. Again, I'm not a doctor, this is just how like I can best explain it, but it would show like what the most prevalent strand of bacteria was and then what the best antibiotic was to treat that. And let me tell you, it was such a process. However, slowly but surely, things started to get better. And I just wanna stress, it was not a walk in the park. Like there were days where I would come back from the doctor, you know, feeling a little bit better, and then I would get a call like 2 days later because we would do another like lab test, and I would get a call 2 days later saying like, you know, you might be feeling better, but like the bacteria is still there and it's like just as strong. And like I would just break down and cry because I was so frustrated and I couldn't figure out like what was wrong with me. Which like looking back, I wish I would have told myself a little bit more like, it's not me that's the problem, it's just my body that's having an issue. But it would be lying to sit here and tell you guys that like it didn't make me feel just a little less than. Again, I feel like not enough women talk about like vaginal health issues that they've had in the past. So when it happens to you, you feel really isolated and you can't help but feel like a little less than. And you feel like less of a woman at times. Honestly, like I'm just gonna go there and say that. I also like felt incredibly bad for my boyfriend during this time because I just felt like he was always having to hear me like complain, and he would come home and always see me like in discomfort and pain. And you know, there were days where like we'd have plans and I would have to cancel them just because like I wasn't feeling good, whether it be my symptoms were super bad or like, you know, the medication was giving me like severe side effects. Like I cannot tell you how many nights I ended up like waking up in the middle of the night and just like throwing up because the medicine was, you know, was really strong. And honestly, like I just wanna thank my boyfriend so much because never once did he make me feel like I was a burden or I was the problem. You know, he was always there to just like help me and, you know, let me know that it was okay and that like he was there if, you know, I needed him to come with me to like any doctor's appointments. Like honestly, that to me is the true example of a man, because he was always there to check on me and he always wanted to be like just as informed on what was going on as I was. So I just like, again, want to thank him so much for like being with me through this process. And I also just like want to thank this doctor as well, because literally like she, I feel like any other doctor like would have given up on me at this point, because there were times where it seemed like that it was just impossible and that I was gonna be on antibiotics for the rest of my life. And she made it very clear to me that she was not going to let that be an option, which instilled hope and confidence in me as well, which kind of brings me back to another point that I want to like stress to you guys, which is like how important it is to find the doctor for you. Not all doctors, not all gynecologists are the same. You know, everybody has like a different personality. So you need to find the one who makes you feel the most comfortable, because like when you're spreading your legs for a stranger, you need to feel at least a little at ease. I mean, you're never gonna feel completely at ease, but you need to find a doctor who, you know, you feel comfortable around and who you feel can like answer your questions and isn't gonna make you feel like you just wanna like crawl into a hole and hide. So after what felt like forever, after what felt like so many lab tests, so many appointments, so many antibiotics, at the end of September of this year, I went in for one final culture and it came back completely clean. I didn't have an ounce of bacteria in my body the UTI that I had been dealing with for over a year was finally gone. I was literally so happy that I can't even describe it. I was so happy that I felt like I could just run like 20 miles and still have enough energy to like do it again. Like I said, before this all happened, I've always been a generally like very healthy person and I'm super, super grateful for that. But it definitely made this process even more frustrating just because I had never had to deal with something like this. I had never had to deal with my body like not wanting to help me heal from something. So the fact that it was like done, literally I felt like I could breathe easier. So ever since September, I have not had to take an actual antibiotic anymore. However, I do kind of briefly want to talk about what has helped me ever since then. So my doctor basically turned me on to three different like vitamins that I now take. So if you are someone who struggles with reoccurring UTIs, this might be something that can really, really help you as well. So one of the things she told me is that reoccurring UTIs can often be due to a vitamin D insufficiency. And a lot of women actually deal with a lack of vitamin D. So even if you don't have reoccurring UTIs, it's often just a really good idea to take vitamin D every day anyways. So every single day, I actually take three of these vitamin D3 vitamins from CVS. They're super, super small. I take them every single day with food just because I find that it kind of upsets my stomach if I don't. But basically, they just look like this. They're super small little gel capsules. And this is what I take every single day. And I honestly find that it has really, really helped. These next two things though, I feel are what have truly, truly helped keep a UTI far, far, far away from me. This first thing right here is D-mannose. Now I get this off of Amazon. This is the brand that I take. It's just called Now, I guess. Basically, this is supposed to help promote a healthy urinary tract. D-mannose, essentially, from what I've like read on it, it's basically a sugar pill almost. This is what they look like. I take three a day before I go to bed, and that way I don't like pee it out. Like if that makes sense, like I take it before bed, that way it's in my system for a while. And then by the time I wake up, it's kind of already absorbed into my system. But essentially what this does is when you take it, it's a sugar pill. Sugar is sticky. So it sticks to the lining of like your bladder from what I understand. So when you're going to the bathroom or if you're ever in a situation where you have to hold your pee for like a second, it makes it so that bacteria can't stick to the wall of your bladder. So when you use the bathroom, the bacteria just slides right off thanks to these handy dandy pills. I actually did a lot of research on D-mannose before I started taking it, and honestly, it's kind of like women's best kept secret, I feel. It's everybody who takes it says that they have, you know, just seen such an improvement in like the fact that they don't get UTIs as often and that just like they feel a lot better as well. And then last but certainly not least, I take these. This is from Pure Co. This is cranberry concentrate organic cranberry pills. I'm sorry to bust what most of you probably think is a fact. However, cranberry juice is actually not that effective when it comes to treating UTIs and maintaining a healthy urinary tract. However, pure organic cranberry pills are. They're super, super helpful when it comes to keeping symptoms away. So I take two of these every single night along with the D-mannose pills. And obviously I haven't had a UTI since then. So I really do feel like these three things combined are definitely really helping and they've kind of changed my life. So that is my story. I know that that was a lot, and it was a lot for me to share, but I feel like it was very, very necessary. For those who have watched through the entire video, if there are any women, young or older than me, who are watching this video who are struggling with the same thing that I was, please know that you are not alone. Having a UTI is nothing to be embarrassed about. It is nothing to be ashamed about. It does not make you any less of a woman. It does not make you gross or dirty. And anybody who tells you that, you should not be listening. It is something that affects thousands and thousands of women every single year, and most women will have at least one UTI in their life. Again, I also just want to stress, if you ever feel like something is wrong, not just when it comes to like your vaginal health, but if you feel like anything is wrong, it is so, so important to go to the doctor and check yourself out. Nobody necessarily enjoys going to the doctor. You know, it's not comfortable for a lot of people. Nobody, you know, gets excited to go to the doctor. However, to ignore your problems is only going to make it worse, you know, in the end. I have so many female friends who are around my age who are like, oh yeah, I've never been to the gynecologist. Like, it scares me. It freaks me out. Here's the thing. It can freak you out, but you have to go. Your health is so important. And if you don't have your health to rely on, then it makes it incredibly hard to do anything else in life. But basically, I just want to kind of go back to the fact that, like, you are not alone if you are dealing with reoccurring UTIs. If you're dealing with a UTI like me that took, you know, over a year to treat, you are not alone. It is going to get better. As long as you are dealing with it, you know, in the way that you should and handling it with a doctor who you trust, it's going to be just fine. I know that it can be frustrating. It's okay to break down. It's okay to have moments of just pure sadness about it. What's not okay is to just kind of like sit in that sadness and that frustration and not do anything about it. If you find a doctor who is telling you that nothing's wrong with you when you feel like there is, or if you find a doctor who keeps trying to tell you it's one thing when you know it's another, it's okay to go and search and find another doctor, because once you find the one who not only you trust, but who will listen to you, it makes the world of a difference. I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. I hope that it was helpful. Please, let's keep the comments nice down below. I know that my Ruby Rocks the World subscriber base is very, very kind, but for those who are just tuning in for the first time today, please be sure to keep the comment section positive and encouraging and loving. Please subscribe if you haven't already and help me grow the Ruby Rocks the World family. It would mean the absolute world to me. And give this video a thumbs up if you would like more videos like this, a bit more of a like mature subject matter, me truly sharing stories that I think will help other people. Please be sure to follow me on all my social media networks. The links are always in the down bar below. I hope you guys are having an awesome day, night, afternoon, whenever you all are watching this, and I will talk to you guys in my next video. Okay, bye everybody.